This video outlines the onboarding process that the Minnesota Department of Human Services Background Studies Division will use to transition or onboard entities to NETStudy 2.0. This video explains how an organization may structure the Sensitive Information Person, or SIP, in NETStudy 2, and gives a brief overview of the onboarding tool that the authorized agent and SIP will use to complete the onboarding process. There are several terms used throughout this video and the onboarding materials where a definition may be useful. Entity means a facility, program, or agency initiating background study requests under Minnesota Statutes, Chapter 245C. This includes, but is not limited to, programs licensed by the Minnesota Department of Human Services or the Minnesota Department of Health, programs serving children or youth licensed by the Minnesota Department of Corrections, unlicensed personal care provider organizations, PCA choice programs, supplemental nursing service agencies, personnel agencies, educational programs, and professional services agencies. Authorized agent means a managing employee for personal care provider organizations, a controlling person for programs regulated by the Minnesota Department of Health, or a license holder or controlling individual for all other entities. Sensitive information person means the individual designated to receive sensitive background study information who is capable of determining, upon request of the department, whether a background study subject is providing direct contact services in one or more of the license holders' programs or services, and, if so, at which location or locations. Based on the implementation schedule for NETStudy 2.0, entities will be contacted to onboard to the new system. Entities will receive an introductory email that contains a letter from DHS Inspector General Jerry Kerber and the onboarding guide with instructions. Because DHS will initiate contact with an entity's authorized agent by email, it is important for entities to update and maintain current records with DHS. Entities will be given approximately 2 weeks to review the introductory materials so that the authorized agents in an organization with multiple entities have time to determine how to structure their SIP or SIPs in NETStudy 2.0. For single entities, the authorized agent will designate a sensitive information person for their entity. However, for organizations with multiple entities, the new NETStudy 2.0 system offers more flexibility in how background study determinations of workers and volunteers may apply to your organization. The authorized agent or agents for the organization are responsible to designate background study sensitive information persons for each entity using the onboarding tool. A person may be the SIP for one or more entities that are owned or operated by the same organization, or there may be one SIP per entity, or a combination of these options as shown in the next three diagrams. The next three diagrams show an organization with a legal relationship to four entity programs represented as triangles. There is also an animated figure named George who represents an employee of the organization. Under option one, a single SIP is responsible for all entities under an organization structure. Here, the organization's authorized agent or agents designated a single person as a SIP for each of the four entities. In this example, a single SIP is responsible for all entities under the organization structure. To illustrate how this structure affects an organization's ability to transfer employees across its entities, let's examine which of the four entities that an employee with a cleared background study, like George, could provide services for without each of the four entities having to submit a new background study. Entity Program 1 submitted the background study for George, so George can work for Entity Program 1. George could also work for Entity Program 2, Entity Program 3, and Entity Program 4. Thus, with one SIP for all the organization's entities, George may provide services at any of the organization's four entities. Under Option 2, the organization's authorized agent, or agents, selected a different sensitive information person for each of the organization's four entities. To illustrate how Option 2 affects an organization's ability to transfer employees across its entities, let's examine which of the four entities that an employee with a cleared background study, like George, could provide services for. Entity Program 1 submitted the background study for George, so he can work for Entity Program 1. However, Entity Program 2 has a different sensitive information person from Entity Program 1. Thus, George could not work for Entity Program 2 unless Entity Program 2 initiated a new background study for George. Similarly, because Entity Program 3 and 4 each have a different sensitive information person from the entity program that submitted the background study, George could not work for either Entity Program 3 or Entity Program 4 unless those entities initiated a new background study for him. With this structure, a person with a cleared background study may only provide services at the entity or program where the background study was submitted. In order to provide services at any of the organization's other entities, a new background study would be required for each entity where the person would be providing services. Option 3 is a combination of options 1 and 2. Under Option 3, the organization's authorized agent, or agents, designated one SIP for multiple entities while designating a single SIP for other entities. To illustrate how Option 3 affects an organization's ability to transfer employees across its entities, let's examine which of the four entities that an employee with a cleared background study, like George, could provide services for. Entity Program 1 submitted the background study for George, so George could work for Entity Program 1. Because Entity Program 2 has the same SIP as Entity Program 1, George could also provide services for Entity Program 2. However, Entity Program 3 and 4 each have a different sensitive information person from the entity program that submitted the background study. Thus, George could not work for either Entity Program 3 or Entity Program 4. With this structure, a person with a cleared background study may only provide services at the entity or program with the same SIP. In order to provide services at an entity with a different SIP, a new background study would be required for that entity. Approximately 2 weeks after receiving the introductory email that includes the SIP structure options, the authorized agent will receive an email with a hyperlink labeled, "Click this link to log in to the NETStudy 2.0 onboarding tool." By clicking the link, the authorized agent can access the onboarding tool to complete the SIP designation process. After clicking the hyperlink, the authorized agent will be directed to the onboarding tool. The first page includes a list of all the entities that the authorized agent is currently assigned to. In addition, the page includes the duties and responsibilities of the authorized agent and expectations for an entity's sensitive information person. It is important that the authorized agent understands these responsibilities and expectations before designating a SIP or SIPs for their organization's entities. The authorized agent must electronically sign and attest that he or she understands and is responsible for the authorized agent requirements and is accountable for the actions of the person or persons designated as a sensitive information person in NETStudy 2.0. At the top of the next page, the current persons identified as a sensitive information person for the authorized agent's entities will be listed. The authorized agent must create a new SIP record even if the SIP will not be changing. The SIP record includes the SIP's name, telephone number, and email address. If the authorized agent is associated with more than one entity and will be designating different SIPs for its entities, the authorized agent must create multiple SIP records by clicking the Click to Add Another hyperlink. The next page will display a list of all the entities that the authorized agent is associated with, along with a drop-down selector for each entity. The drop-down selector will include all of the SIP records created on the prior page. The authorized agent must select a SIP from the drop-down for each entity listed. The authorized agent finalizes the SIP selections by clicking the Submit button. After the authorized agent submits the SIP designations in the onboarding tool, an email will be sent to each person that the authorized agent designated as a SIP in the prior step. The email will include a hyperlink labeled "Click this link to log in to the NETStudy 2.0 onboarding tool." The SIP must complete this portion before the entity will receive access to NETStudy 2.0. After clicking the hyperlink, the SIP will be directed to the onboarding tool. At the top of the page, there is a list that includes all of the entities for which they have been designated as a SIP. In addition, this page includes the duties and responsibilities of a sensitive information person. At the bottom of the page, the SIP must electronically sign and attest that he or she will carry out the duties and the responsibilities of the sensitive information person in NETStudy 2.0. After the SIP submits the Background Study Sensitive Information Person User Agreement in the onboarding tool, the authorized agent and the SIP will receive an onboarding receipt with the organization's SIP designations and an electronically signed and timestamped copy of the NETStudy 2.0 User Agreement. Within 2 to 3 days, each SIP that completes the SIP designation process will receive an email containing a system-generated password and a link to the NETStudy 2.0 system. The SIP's username will be their email address. By clicking on the hyperlink, the SIP will be directed to NETStudy 2.0. At this point, the onboarding process is complete and the entity is considered fully transitioned to NETStudy 2.0 and may begin submitting background studies in the new system. Once transitioned to NETStudy 2.0, the entity should discontinue use of the old NETStudy portal. Thank you for your time in learning more about the exciting transition to NETStudy 2.0. If you have questions about onboarding, please contact DHS by email at dhs.netstudy2@state.mn.us or by phone at 651-431-6625.